Here in the Lowcountry, life revolves around water. It always has. Between our history and our culture, it defines us. We're intimately dependent on healthy estuaries and clean coastlines, both for economic reasons and to sustain our current way of life. Year after year, our waterways attract thousands of visitors, and it's the reason that many of us call the Lowcountry home. These same waterways harbor the biodiversity of life that makes this place thrive. I'm proud of our clean water and healthy ecosystems. But is our water always clean? In some places, the quality of our water has deteriorated to the point where it's unhealthy for us to swim, fish, or harvest. As our population increases, so does our strain on the environment.
Clean water keeps us healthy. It's only natural that we return the favor and make sure that we protect our waterways from pollution. And that pollution can come from roadway runoff to storm drains, lawn care chemicals, and even pet waste. So we as a public need to make sure that we're doing everything we can to protect these waterways and preserve them for future generations.
I'm meeting with a friend who has dedicated himself to keeping our waterways clean.
Hey Cyrus, how you doing?
Well, how are you doing?
Pretty good.
See you.
Yeah, thanks for coming out here. So you're the founder of the Charleston Waterkeeper. For someone who's never heard about that before, I mean, what is the Charleston Waterkeeper?
So in essence, we as an organization give a voice to our waterways, and we give a voice to the users of our waterways. Charleston Waterkeeper is one of just about 215 waterkeeper organizations that exist worldwide. So our goal really as an organization is to protect, promote, and restore Charleston's waterways and make sure that the public has swimmable, drinkable, and fishable water here in the Lowcountry.
I notice this sign right here. It's a DHEC sign, and it says, don't harvest shellfish from this area. What does that really mean?
So it's really interesting. The way that Charleston's developed, early on upon its settlement, Charleston was actually referred to as Oyster Point because of the plethora of oysters along the southern perimeter of the peninsula. And as the city was developed, those oyster beds that were harvestable began dying off due to our impact on our waterways. And today, DHEC is the regulatory agency, and they assure that we as citizens don't harvest oysters from areas that might be polluted. And so a place like this that's in the middle of the downtown developed peninsula, it's a precautionary effort to assure that we aren't consuming something that might have high levels of bacteria or pathogens that might be harmful to us. So it's unfortunately a byproduct of our developing a once very pristine, untouched natural resource.
Where is this bacteria coming from?
Yeah.
And how's it entering this waterway, and what does it do once it gets there?
Sure, great question. So we're looking specifically at an indicator bacteria called Enterococcus. So one thing that we do is we have a water quality monitoring program currently that monitors every single week 15 locations throughout the Lowcountry. And what we do is we look at the quality of the water through the lens of bacteria. In essence, we're looking at the amount of bacteria present, which would suggest that there's sewage and there's other pathogens that are harmful to you and I, that are harmful to shellfish in the water. Where that stuff is coming from could be coming anywhere from stormwater runoff to failing septic systems or septic systems that aren't properly maintained or treated. Could be infrastructure that's old and degraded that might not be properly working. Might be illegal discharges from boaters, both recreational and commercial. And so understanding that there's a slew of potential sources, we really have to do root cause analysis and peel back the layers of the onion to determine, all right, if this creek is high in bacteria, what are the potential sources that could be contributing to the high bacteria levels? And we work backwards from there.
Stormwater. Every time it rains, our yards, parking lots, and roadways are flushed with water, which is then drained into our watershed to avoid flooding. And in that process, stormwater picks up contaminants such as lawn care chemicals, pet waste, oils, and even solid refuse. Instead of going to a treatment facility like sewage, stormwater travels through drains, gutters, and creeks directly into our environment. Once there, these contaminants pollute our waterways by incubating harmful types of bacteria and pathogens. These things not only make us sick, but they have harmful effects on the wildlife that inhabit these areas. Over half of the impaired waterways in Charleston are due to bacteria. One common source of that is discharge from boaters.
We recognize that we could actually make a measurable impact by curbing the source of bacteria and of pollution from recreational boaters. Wow. Oftentimes, if there isn't enough pump out infrastructure for a boater to use, let's say they're at a marina, they don't move their boat, for whatever reason they can't get the boat to a stationary facility to remove their waste, oftentimes and unfortunately boaters choose to do the most convenient thing for them would be to discharge illegally overboard. Now that's going to have a massive impact, especially collectively if you have a lot of boaters doing this, on our communal right to clean water. And so one of the things that we did is we initiated this program. We purchased number two, which is our pump out boat. It's our second boat. And in essence, it's a boat that's specially designed to go out and remove the sewage and remove waste from onboard holding tanks of recreational boats. And we go out on the water just about 2 days a week, year round, and we offer a free, convenient service to anyone in the Charleston Harbor area so that they have no excuse to dump overboard.
Yeah.
If it is pumped out by the number two or at a designated pump out station, the waste will make its way to a public facility. Here, the wastewater is intensely treated before it can safely enter the environment.
Today, we've prevented about 5,500 gallons of sewage from entering into our waterways illegally and therefore impacting your and my right to clean water.
The number two, huh?
Right. We got whimsical with our name.
Yeah. What are some things that just your everyday Low Country resident, I mean, what are some things they can do to make sure that we have clean water today and into the future?
Yeah, and in terms of active steps, you know, we all need to make sure that our footprint on and around Charleston's waterways are as small as possible. So if we have pets, picking up after our pets. If we have lawns, making sure that we're not introducing any harmful chemicals or pesticides or fertilizers that are eventually going to work their way into our waterways. If we have a picnic or if we go to the beach, ensuring that all the trash that we bring in, we pack out. And if we're a boater, if you're a fisherman, making sure that we're keeping an eye out. If we see problems, if we see impairments or threats to our water, report them. And so the benefit of clean water for everybody is obvious, but the one thing that we each individually have to recognize is, why is clean water important for me? And oftentimes that answer might not be completely black and white for every single individual. Now, the users of the water who use it every single weekend or every single day, the answer to that is obvious. But for those that aren't actively using the water, it's going to take a little time to recognize in their individual lives why is clean water in Charleston important to them. And guarantee there's an answer for every single person, regardless of where they live, regardless of their lifestyle, regardless of their background. And that's the beauty of Charleston's waterways, is it is that common denominator, and it is the common thread that connects each and every single one of us here in the Lowcountry.
We can learn from people like Cyrus and the Charleston Waterkeepers. So we can all do our part to keep our waters clean, even if that means just being informed. Take the time to get to know your watershed. Go out and enjoy what we in the Lowcountry are so fortunate to have. Our water is central to our culture, our food, our economy, and our way of life. Each one of us is responsible for our own impact. Each one of us is a steward of our generation. And it is up to each one of us to protect this amazing gift.